الشيطان الرجيم. وإذا جاءهم أمر من الأمن أو الخوف أذاعوا به ولو ردوه إلى الرسول وإلى أولي الأمر منهم لعلمه الذين يستنبطونه منهم. ولولا فضل الله عليكم ورحمته لاتبعتم الشيطان إلا قليلا. صدق الله العظيم. وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين. والحمد لله رب العالمين. وإذا جاءه أمر من الأمن أو الخوف. When news concerning peace or fear comes to them, أذاعوا به, they go about spreading it. وَلَوْ رَدُّوهُ إِلَى الرَّسُولِ, had they referred it to the messenger, وَإِلَىٰ أُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْهُمْ, and to those having authority among them, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَهُ مِنْهُمْ, the truth of the matter would have come to the knowledge of those of them who are able to investigate. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, but for Allah's grace upon you, وَرَحْمَتُهُ, and mercy, لَتَّبَعْتُمُ الشَّيْطَانِ, you would have followed the shaitan, إِلَّا قَلِيلًا, except a few of you. So this ayah refers to the munafiqeen, according to a majority of mufassireen, that whenever some news would come to them, they would go about spreading it in the general public, rather than properly bringing it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam first, or at least the sahaba closer to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the senior sahaba. They would not do that, but they would go about spreading it. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying that had they brought it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa ila ulil amri, and the people of authority. So if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not there, for example, because the rule is universal in general, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not available, then the people of authority. Who are the people of authority? The people who are governing a place. And as we had discussed in detail, also the people, if in matters of deen, the people of fiqh, the people of tafaqquh fi deen, the people of understanding of deen, fuqaha. If they had brought it to them, لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَ مِنْهُمْ, then the truth of the matter, the reality of the matter, would have come to the knowledge of الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَ مِنْهُمْ, those who do istanbat from among you, those who investigate. Mustanbit has written is that water when a well is dug deep, the first water that oozes out from the depth of the earth is called mustanbit water. So here the meaning is that those who investigate, those who have the training to investigate, those who are authorized and have the training to investigate. Therefore, in matters of deen, and this ruling is not general, is general, is not specific only about the munafiqeen spreading false news about the enemy, but also all sorts of matters, worldly and dini matters. Whenever they would think something, then whenever they would find something, whenever something would come to their mind, or whenever they'd hear something from somewhere, they will go about spreading it. Now if you look at our today's life, one big fitna of our time is that we'll get messages on WhatsApp and Facebook and wherever else, and we will go about spreading them. In the tafsir of this ayah, there is a Hafiz Imamuddin Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he has quoted that the shan and nuzul, the background of this ayah, is that Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anh heard from someone that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has divorced all his wives. He came out of his house, and as he was going towards Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at the footstep of the Masjid al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also heard the people, the general public, talking about this, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has divorced all his wives. So he said, he was one of the ulil amr, he was one of the senior sahaba, and this is the difference between common people and the people of tafaqquh and understanding and intellect. He said, we should investigate this matter. And he went straight to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked the Prophet ﷺ very plainly, Ya Rasulullah, have you divorced all your wives? The Prophet ﷺ said, no. He immediately came back, and right from the footstep of the Masjid Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, "What you are spreading is false news. What you are spreading is false news." So the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said, this the hadith is also quoted in the tafsir of this ayah, that for a person to be a liar in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is enough that whatever they hear, whatever they get, they spread it onwards to other people. For them being a liar, it is enough for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So us forwarding messages, it does not have to be pertaining to deen. This is a general thing. Somebody gives you a medical advice. Now there's so many, we call this totke in Urdu, right? These small tips and tricks, small hacks, people get them from somewhere and it is forwarded on to so many other people. In matters of deen, it is even more serious. When you hear something, you have no idea about the background of that person, and you have made them your murabbi. You've made them your source of deen. How is it so that you learn something from the internet or from anybody walking on the road, or you hear it from somebody, or you get a message? Our mashayikh say that even if those messages mention the book and the hadith, number of the hadith, even then you should not forward it until and unless you have seen it for yourself, that hadith on that number in the book yourself, or at least you have confirmed it with somebody of knowledge, then you can forward it. But people like to become scholars of deen. So something would come, be it a medical thing, be it a life, worldly life thing, be it a deeny thing, very easily, very lightly, people will forward it. They do not think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is enough for a person to be a liar, that they forward on things that they hear from wherever and without confirming. The other thing that has driven from this ayah is istambat. As I said, mustambit water. Istambat is deep research and extracting the ruling. So this ayah is also proof for istambat. Ulil Amr, as we had discussed later, discussed in detail in the previous ayah, Atiyur Allah, Atiyur Rasul, Ulil Amri Minkum, under that ayah, Ulil Amr refers to people of authority. The people of authority in deen, people of authority in this world. So in matters of worldly discipline and function, the example was given that, you know, how many police stations should be somewhere, how many post offices should be in an area to serve that area. That kind of things, Ulil Amr would be the authorities, the government authorities. In matters of deen and fiqh and rulings of sharia, the authority will be the fuqaha and the ulama. So the fuqaha and the ulama, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding people that they should, whenever there is something in deen, of course, I don't want to talk about the things of the world, that is very apparent that nobody wants to enforce something. But if there is matters of deen, before making an opinion, before forming your own opinion with your own thinking or intellect about something, it should be reverted to Ulil Amr. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that they will find out. لَعَلِمَهُ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَنْبِطُونَ مِنْهُمْ. The reality, the truth of the matter will be found out by the people who have the authority and the training to do istambat, to find out the real meaning. وَلَوْلَا فَضْلُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَتُهُ لَاتَّبَعْتُمُ الشَّيْطَانَ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. If it was not for the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most of you would have started following the shaitan, and very few would have been saved. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from following the shaitan by spreading false news, unconfirmed news. It doesn't even have to be false or true, unconfirmed news. The Prophet ﷺ has said that is enough for somebody to be a liar. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Qur'an alladhi ahluka wa khassatuk. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين صلى الله تعالى على خير خلقه سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.